The Sky Rocket is one of the most thrilling and popular rides at Kennywood Park. But to appreciate this cool coaster, you have to look back in time to realize it replaced another popular ride, the Turnpike, that allowed you to drive a car and whip around the course.
The Turnpike was especially fond of. Even though as a little kid I thought it was a cool ride, it was really my first ride when I worked here as a seasonal employee in college. I worked on that ride, so I had fond memories of the Turnpike ride.
Because riders often smashed into cars in front of them, park officials shut it down in 1985, replacing the gas-powered cars with electric ones in 1987, before retiring the Turnpike in 2010. Some other rides have been altered over the years, including a Kennywood staple, Noah's Ark.
I remember being scared to death of Noah's Ark.
Quinn may have been scared as a kid, but once he started working here as a teen, the signature ride became one of his favorites.
There's a section of outside of Noah's Ark that you walk across this walkway, and there were air jets under there, and they would blow up women's skirts. And people would say, well, why'd you get rid of those air jets? Well, women don't wear skirts anymore, so there's no fun in it anymore. But I do remember that. I always thought the guy that had, that was his sole job, was to blow, the air jets up women's skirts. And I thought, what a cool career he had.
Quinn also reminisced about the old Kennywood currency, the days when patrons had to buy tickets to get onto rides before the park changed to the pay one price for admission. Those strip tickets were coveted.
I used to have an uncle that ran the place in those days, so I didn't have to worry about buying any, really. I used to get wads and wads of them, and people used to look at me when I was only 8 or 10 years old. They'd look at me in line with this wad of tickets going, what is this kid now?
You don't have to walk very far in the park before running into a convenient quick-serve place to grab a bite to eat. But it wasn't always that way. Families took a break from the rides and sat down for meals at the full-serve restaurant.
But I do remember it was wait-to-serve. We actually had to be very polite and proper. It was like dining at a fine restaurant, although it wasn't. They were tablecloths in those days, too. I was really surprised. So that's gone.
One of the food items that has never changed, the potato patch fries. Your choice with salt, vinegar, cheese, you name it. It has been that way since 1972. The fries, an attraction all by themselves.
They rank French fries in the amusement park industry. The patch has, for every year of its ranking, I think it's somewhere like 15 years in a row, has been voted the best fries in any amusement park in the United States.
Another reason why this place is so special, the variety of new and old rides. The turtle, for example, is one of only two turtle rides still in operation in the world. Out of the 550 documented turtle rides ever manufactured, generations keep coming back here to sit in the shell.
It's not a sexy ride. It's not a modern-day ride. People rode it with their parents, who rode it with their parents, who rode it with their parents. So it's more of a guilt type of ride. In order to understand now, you have to understand then. And so, that's why we're still in business to this day and age. We understand who we are, what we are, and how to keep who and what we are going.